Hello and welcome everyone. This is Lavender Sky Panther. Today is Wednesday, February 3rd, 2021, and today's topic is called Sky Sweep. It's a collection of images and sky observations happening between January 29th and February 2nd, 2021. And here's just an alternate cover slide I was toying with called Sky Sweeping. I decided to go with the other one, see which one you like better. And before we get into the sky observations, I'd like to say good day, osio, how, buongiorno, guten tag, kia ora, jambo, kedu, buenos dias, bonjour, ni hao, tien dobre, konnichiwa, dobro henya, annyeonghaseyo, buotarji, dobiden, aloha winala, kalimera, and hudendach. And today's starter image is just of a strawberry frosted donut with sprinkles on it. I'm just putting that in for a little happy factor. I hope just seeing it makes you smile. It's horrible for your health, but it was delicious. Anyway, let's get into sky observations. And before I get into these, I'd like to say a heartfelt thanks if you're returning to the show, and a huge embracing welcome if you're new to this channel. And if you are new, I'm going to be referring to some of these slides as original photo or enhanced photo. When I say enhanced, I simply mean that I've edited attributes of the photo, such as color, saturation, brightness, and contrast, things of that nature, just to better highlight some areas of interest we're going to be looking at. And on that note, I also like to sometimes put letters just to call your attention to different areas we're going to be looking at. So let's get going. The title of this slide is just Strange Cloud and Quotes Activity and Cloaking Objects. So we're looking at areas A and B for right now to start with anyway. And I start to see some cloud, strange cloud activity forming the outline of, if you look at the void of this or an imprint of it, you know, a triangular form with rounded corners and the same thing over here. So it just shows me that by the strange nature and the way these clouds, let's just say, are configured, and there's a lot of attributes to these that, you know, call into question of what's going on. It seems to be a little fuzzy and out of focus. I call these staccato clouds when they're kind of grouped in a strange way and seem a little bit blurry. If you see some of my other shows, you'll see better examples of this. But anyway, let's keep going. We'll look at this with some enhancement. And actually, if you have this up on a laptop screen, squint your eyes. If it's on a smaller device and the overall scale of this is shrunken down, you'll probably see it. But where I was at first, just looking at these two triangular forms with curved edges, actually, if you look at the overall shape, it looks like an even bigger triangular form with rounded edges and even kind of curved. So it's a very interesting thing happening here. Anyway, with any one of these photos, the more you look, the more you're going to find. And as I've mentioned on other shows, where I tag some key interest, you know, points to look at, there's probably going to be much more happening in any given photo. So if I don't cover something that you'd like to know more about or see it enhanced, just let me know in the comment section below, and I'll be happy to include that in a future show. All right, so here's on the left the original, and the right's the enhanced version. We'll just focus on the right hand first. Just because you can see this shape, it's like a kite shape forming. Look at this straight edge here, symmetrical straight edge over here, same thing coming down here. So whenever we see geometry in the sky, whether it's composed of clouds in this case, or whether it's like a imprint, or you just see like clouds forming around something, creating something like this, it just shows me there's got to be some type of cloaking object happening in there, because unless it's just a spherical form, you know, triangular forms. I've even seen hexagons and pentagonal forms up in the sky. If you've seen some of my other shows, those don't occur naturally, you know, in a natural cloud-filled sky. But anyway, let's keep going. And if we look on the left and the right, you know, we see a spherical form here. Also something curious happening up in here, triangular in form. I'm going to keep going, moving through some of these pretty quickly and just spend a little more time on the ones that have a little more going on in them. On this one, we're looking south at a sunrise. What caught my attention was A. Not only was the cloud distribution a little strange in this case, but I started to see a clear outline of a rectilinear or kind of square-like form happening in there. So we go to the right to the enhanced version, and you can see, you know, it looks like a cut line, very clear, with edges and right angles. And again, when we see right angles up in the sky, that's not natural. There's also something interesting happening here where my cursor is going. It looks like something cloaking right there to me. So anyway, we go from 8.1 to 8.2 to look at more enhancement. In this case, I took out the color. Just sometimes, as I've mentioned on other shows, if you have color and you take it out and make it black and white or white grayscale, you start to see things in a different way between the way the brain and the eye work. Or conversely, if you have black and white and can bring in some color, you know, again, your mind and eye start to see things in a different way. And some more interesting detail tends to pop out. Anyway, as you follow my cursor, you can see it, you know, this line incised around whatever this cloud material is. And now also, you're going to see me talking a lot about cloaking objects. Those can be 3D, so something that's, you know, tactile, you can touch it, knock on it, so to speak. Or it could be talking about interdimensional objects that kind of, you know, are more phantom-like in appearance. Or it could be a 3D object that is in the middle of phasing in and out of state. So anyway, we're going to be talking a lot about things like that too. Anyway, let's keep moving. So this is now strange cloud and quotes activity and cloaking object. So this was on a morning paddleboarding in a canal, and actually I wasn't even looking really up at the sky. I was just taking an overall photo of the overall scene. But then I noticed this very clear and pronounced triangular form at letter A. So we're going to look at 8.1 and look at this undeniable, you know, symmetrical geometry. Again, that does not happen normally in nature to form a perfect triangle. Okay, this one's just called strange cloud activity again and cloaking objects. This is looking along the top of the rim of a cloud. Do check out other shows that I've done called Rim Watching 2, or there's another one about imprints and objects where, you know, it's even clearer in those shows that it seems that there's some cloaking activity objects that like to stay perched or, you know, be situated poised along the top of a cloud line, and then they tend to launch off. So I've been noticing that a lot lately. This one is, this is looking toward the afternoon hours, at sunset. But anyway, look at this. You know, we see a clear object here and something forming here. So we're going to look at the right at the enhanced version, where we see more of this pointed ellipse body behind some cloaking material. And when I say cloaking material, I don't know if that's just water vapor or plasma or something else. It's hard to say, so I'm just going to call it generic cloaking material with the default kind of probably landing more toward the plasma side of things. But anyway, we definitely see something kind of floating and hovering, whether it was in the cloud and is now emerging or not, hard to say, or if it was just like sitting on top. But definitely that's something else, because if the entire cloud line is marching along in one direction here, more or less horizontal, and then we have something springing off in a totally different direction, that tells you it's more than likely a cloaking object of some type. Okay, this is just, again, more of strange cloud activity and cloaking objects. In this case, it was also just a weird general glare and glow coming from behind some heavy veiling of some type here. I'm not sure if that was chemtrail activity or caused by something else, but definitely there's a thickness in the air, more than just condensation from anything, let's just say. So anyway, we're going to look at this with some... There also seemed to be a pattern kind of emerging here, so we're going to look at it with some enhancement. And here we go. You just see there seems to be some kind of imprint, you know, in and among this stuff, which must be some kind of heavier cloaking material. And then look at just the strange, it's almost like brush marks, you know, going this way, different concentration of them down here. It's just, you know, no way, shape, or form a natural sky in the background here. And then we've got this really odd, I'm going to just say cloud in quotes down here, because it's got some pointed edges to it, so it tells me something's more than likely cloaking in here. And we have a peak here, you know, looks like a triangle's hidden in and behind this thing. So anyway, just a lot of strangeness going on in this scene, but see what you think. Okay, this one is more strange cloud activity in quotes, cloaking objects. We're going to look at area A, because I see this rounded form. Looks, you know, very elliptical, you know, very clear edge to it. We start to see a triangular form and imprint happening up here. So we're going to look at this with some more enhancement and zooming in a bit. We still see this very perfectly round, you know, form. Looks like very elliptical. And again, the imprint's here. So what's happening in this scene? Probably a lot more than we can see at initial glance here. Okay, now this is just called Air Elemental Sky Wisp. I've noted this on other shows with air elementals in the title, things of that nature, where these seem to be more ethereal, otherworldly forms. In recent looking around on other YouTube channels that cover not only sky phenomena, but other kind of otherworldly things, I heard a comment mentioned that kind of prompted me to believe that these could be plasma, liquid plasma type forms that come into our atmosphere to help clean it up. So I've noticed these appear in the neighborhood of chemtrails, in the neighborhood of geometry in the sky, and it seems to overtake them. So I do think that these come in and do a little sky sweep. That's why I called the show that in the title. I think they come in and do like a cleanup of either the chemtrails or any maybe more negative aligned entities in the sky. That's just a theory for right now until I can prove it more. But anyway, we're going to look at A here with some enhancement. And as we do that, we just see there's just a different structure to this thing. It's more crystalline in nature. Could be plasma, could be some other material. Say what you think. Okay, this one is more strange cloud activity in quotes and cloaking objects. I'm going to spend time more on the enhanced version because it's easier to see things. But what caught my attention on the original photo was just this weird ethereal type of light popping up in the background, highlighting certain areas, almost like backlighting this locally. And it had an otherworldly feel, and I've covered that on other shows too. Now we look at the right, the enhanced version, and you can see a little bit more detail. You know, look at this, almost like a nautilus swing around. And what's this? You know, there's like a hole popping up through here. Very, you know, beautiful, but strange, you know, white, blue light. Again, very otherworldly and beautiful. And then we're going to look at the same scene after it morphs a little, like a second later. And look at this, you know, we've got one element here, again, this little hole here. See point two, we're seeing like a triangular form with rounded corners. So we look to the right at the enhanced version, and look at it, looks like this little ball-like form kind of detached and pulled away from this down below. I'm going to toggle back to the previous scene, watch that area. So see, it's a solid mass with some like swing-around movement to it. It's a very pronounced curve right there, like a hook. And then bam, it splits off from that thing. So I've got to say that's a cloaking object. Also appears to be something in here as well. So on your own time, when you have a little more time, do go ahead and toggle back to the one we had before, to this one, and note the changes happening at our areas A, B, and C. Okay, this is strange cloud activity once again, cloaking objects, and we look at the left for the original. The right, we'll spend more time there. At 8.1, this little area looked pretty interesting. Also up here, where we get this more like, look like that air elemental, same type of crystalline stuff from before. Just kind of, I think kind of being obscured by some of this other choppy interference of cloud, let's just say. So whenever I see stuff really choppy and blurred to the naked eye, it shows that there's atmospheric, major atmospheric disturbance happening above. And to me, when I see that, that means that there's cloaking craft or something up there generating that activity locally. So see what you think. We're going to look at it. I think zoomed in on that one element, 8.2. It just kind of looks a little bit butterfly-like with two wings. I just wanted to take a look here at what was going on there to see if I could see anything better. And when I enhance it even more, there might be a triangular form, looks like happening in there, a little more solid. Looks like something's hiding in here as well as far as cloaking craft. Then we look at down here below in the lower right, you just see this ethereal white blue light pop out. To me, there's something happening in here as well. And over here to the left, see what you think is going on in the scene. Okay, then we are looking at areas A and B on this particular view. What's weird is you see that this makes almost like a puzzle piece fit between these two pieces. Then that doesn't just occur in nature, you know, it's too precise. So we're going to take a look at this with some enhancement. Meaning, in this case, we took out the color just to try to look at it in a different way. You know, there's something kind of going on here we're going to take another look at even closer. And then B.1, we just see it more clearly. You know how these are like two puzzle pieces. There's also some strange stuff happening in here, but it's a little hard to see in this enhancement, so we want to look at it in a slightly different way coming up. But before that, we're going to look at an original version zoomed in on that one area of A, which now I'm calling A.2. And then we're going to look at it with some enhancement. So now we see like a triangular form over here and a separate form which looks symmetrical. It looks like a bar coming across here with two fins or prongs. You know, so to me that's a craft. And this may be as well here in the triangular form. Also over here we start to see like a circular shape with two prongs in the front with a cutout in the front. So I believe this is also a cloaking craft as well. The telltale sign of this or clear indicator is all of this kind of tufted smoke cascading, you know, over the front. When I say smoke, I'm referring to cloaking material, sorry. Here too, you just see the concentration of it kind of cascading over a form. And here we have an edge with it with even some reflection coming off the top. So to me, you know, can I tell you exactly what it is? No, but I can definitely show you there are some silhouettes of shapes that are not natural and clouds happening here, and I'm calling them cloaking objects. Oh, also, when I say cloaking objects, they could be of advanced ET origin, extraterrestrial origin. Could be also human-made or collaboration between the two. Who knows at this point? But anyway, I think much more will be revealed soon. We're just catching glimpses of things now in the form of cloaking craft. Anyway, we're moving on now to air elementals and sky wisps. So on A, that's the original, and to the right's the enhanced version. And actually, the true color of this would be somewhere in between the two slides. But anyway, on the right, we'll just focus there. So here we go. We have this tufted smoke, this energy. Actually, this might even be where my cursor is. A cloaking object in and of itself, because we can see a form to it. More rigid form. But then this comes out and exits out as very ethereal and wisp-like. And again, I do believe that this type of thing is the stuff that kind of comes in to, you know, clean up anything that really doesn't belong in the atmosphere. And I believe it could be something sent in from other universes, something that has intelligence on its own and knows what to do the cleaning, because whatever happens to our Earth, or including the atmosphere, does have bigger impacts that have a ripple effect through the whole universe. That's what I believe anyway. All right, so here we're going to look at it zoomed in a little bit more with a little more enhancement over here, and you just see how beautiful it is. Again, I can't tell you much more than what my theories are on it, but if you have any great ideas or even just some fun ideas on it, feel free to let me know in the comment section below as well. Okay, this is strange cloud activity and cloaking objects again. On the left, it just seemed that this little grouping didn't, you know, quite fit in with the rest of the cloud activity going on. We also have some clear breaks, almost like puzzle piece fit as well. If you follow my cursor, that starts to be one bigger object. So we're looking at it to the right with enhancement, and sure enough, it looks like this has its own little entity cloaking there. This is another piece here as well, another piece here and here. I'm not sure what's going on here, but it's starting to look very interesting as well. And also note the color signature changes. So whereas these just go dark, and then we have more reddish hue, rose-colored hue, you know, where nothing else around it is. Just very interesting. Okay, this one, on the left is the original, the right's the enhanced version. Just notice some beautiful pink, you know, in the background. This was toward sunset and looking northwest. And then I noticed, you know, just kind of a little shape floating in there. So I thought, let's take a look at it with some enhancement. And here we go. You know, it definitely looks like something is probably cloaking in there. Also, just strange forms also along the rim become more evident. So I do believe there's cloaking craft going on in there as well. Okay, on the left is the original, the right is the enhanced version. On this one, not only was this overall assembly of cloud, let's just say, kind of strange, you can see it better in the enhanced version, but it also looked like, if you look on the right-hand side at 8.1, that this looks more like a spherical object or egg-shaped type of object, and actually when you go back to the left, it almost looks like it's zooming in with a trail of its own. I don't know if you can see that on the right-hand side, the enhanced version. So it just seems to kind of sweep in, and it's kind of at the top of this other strange cloud configuration. And then we have B.1, we're looking at, you know, more of an object-like thing starts to emerge in the enhanced view. Just a strange kind of overall picture here. See what you see in there as well. Now we're zooming in on that a little bit more. So A.2, again, it looks like that like egg-shaped thing or elliptical thing. Kind of just zoomed in out of the sky from the upper left-hand part of the photo. On the right's the enhanced version, so you can see there's almost like a negative, like a void of this trail, like a split trail coming down with this thing. And you can see, you know, the way this kind of strange cloaking or cloud material kind of cradles this thing. But, you know, this has a different energy signature because it's got more of a reddish, you know, tone to it, whereas this is cooler in the purple, indigo, you know, blue range. So what is going on here? Also, this looks very interesting where my cursor is. That's like a flattened ellipse with another raised element to it. So this could be the top of a bigger craft happening below, which is what I think is happening, or it's just some kind of platform that this thing is landing on or springing, I don't know. It's not springing off, but maybe something is springing off as this is coming in. See what you think is going on there. It's very fascinating either way. Okay, here's more that we're going to look at in the field of cloaking objects and strange cloud and quotes activity. So look at this overall shape. You know, I just see this floating by, and, you know, it really doesn't fit in with any other natural clouds. We also have the kind of that puzzle piece effect happening in here. So we're definitely going to look at this with some enhancement. And here we go. You know, we just see elements popping out that seem to have more rigid structure and symmetry. Again, we've got a whole puff and field of this cloaking material cascading around this thing. So to me, this is definitely an overall craft with like two different little, who knows, like jets or fins coming off the side. You know, it's symmetrical. And then we have an object up in here in cloak as well, which might be just this portion or this overall shadowy portion. I'm not sure. Some kind of little element happening down here too that's a part of this whole thing. See what you think though. Okay, more views on other strange cloud activity with cloaking objects or craft. And this one, we're putting enhancement on it, and we see darker elements happening in here, and where you see 8.1, that even looks like something with a trail zooming up off to the right. We're going to look at this more. Here we go at 8.2. Here's that little trail I was speaking of. Just looks like something like decided to zoom off and take off this way. Again, when you look at other cloud activity living decades on this planet, we mostly just had cumulus clouds in this area of the country, in the U.S. and Florida, south of Florida. And in that case, you just had predictable cumulus-type clouds moving across horizontally. You never had stuff that was horizontal like this and also coming off an angle. That's why I'm saying there's cloaking craft in here. That's one of the reasons, anyway. And here we go with some more enhancements so you can see it. You know, it just looks like a little trail, and it has intelligence. It's just, you know, zooming off on its own. It looks like something like that's happening here, too. Okay, now we're going to look at more air elementals and sky wisps. I believe that's what's going on here. And we start to see interesting shapes forming, you know, in this wisp kind of overall composition. Also, where B is, that might be an imprint. It looks like a teardrop forming. So we're going to look at this with some enhancement. And it just looks beautiful. Again, I believe the role is to come in and help clean up the atmosphere. But I'm not sure. But this is definitely a different phenomenon that was not around living here decades on the planet observing clouds. Okay, so now with the sun setting, it's picking up some red-pink color. This is looking west-southwest. And just look at the beautiful form of this. You know, I put enhancement on it to the right, and it just almost looks like a rose. Just very beautiful, very elegant. We're going to look at another view of it, and in this case, we pick up a little neighbor, and this looks like a very symmetrical triangular form. So I'm going to say that this is a little cloaking craft, you know, zooming up in this direction, and that this is in a more ethereal, you know, type of air elemental or sky wisp. And we're going to just look at it with more contrast zoomed in, just how beautiful this is. There is some internal structure and intelligence to this thing. And then again, you know, to me this looks like a cloaking craft of some kind. All right, we're going to look at more strange cloud in quotes and cloaking craft. And we're going to look back to the west. The other one we just looked at was more to the south. And we have a clean edge here. You know, we still have this tufted, what I call cloaking material, like tufted smoke or cloud concentration, and something strange, disturbance happening in here. So we're going to look at it with some contrast, and we see different color signature happening down here. Well, we've got pure white happening up in here, little crystalline sparks of white. So that tells me this is definitely a cloaking craft. We're going to look at it a little bit later, then we lose all this detail of the turbulence or whatever was going on, the disturbance in here. It becomes more flat and even, and we'll look at that with some slightly different enhancement. Again, you see this tufted plasma or smoke, whatever that is, this cloaking material covering a darker object beyond. So, and there's even something kind of detached and happening off of here. So to me, that's definitely cloaking craft. All right, this one is just cloaking object. This is looking off to the east at about close to 5:30 p.m. And the upper left is the overall scene, just to give you the context of how, where my cursor is, that triangular form started to really stand out in, you know, the neighborhood of all these other types of quote-unquote clouds going by. So we're just going to look at areas A, B, and C on this one. So A and B, look at these two pieces down below. A second later, look to the right, they start to converge and get closer to each other, while still maintaining this kind of jigsaw puzzle piece, you know, split. And then if we look at C, it seems to just be kind of floating there. But then we look at CC.1, it looks like it's kind of taking off with a trail behind it. So we're going to look at this with some enhancement, and this is what we get. Here you can definitely see this cloaking material around a darker object with a straight edge. It looks like something else is moving in the same direction that way beyond. And here we go to our A and Bs. So here you see how this form is hugging it. This triangular form seems to be pulled away a bit. Look at also the tufted smoke happening in front of the point of this triangular form. And note these little segments behind. And now we go to the right, a split second later, and look at the formation of this overall thing. So this thing starts to extend out farther ahead. It was nice and tight before. Now it's, you know, shooting out ahead of this thing. And then, you know, look at the position of these pieces. These seem to come more into focus, into view, you know, more so than here. And they come in tighter to the body of this thing. So what is going on? I have no idea. But I'm just putting it out there. Maybe you have some good ideas on it. All right, this is just cloaking objects. What caught my attention was this kind of more perfect capsule or elliptical shape. And then also this kind of negative imprint of a triangle forming. We're going to look at that with some enhancement. And here you can just see this imprint of a triangle a little bit better. And I couldn't really pick up anything in here, but I still see that pointed elliptical shape. And then something very interesting seems to pop up out of this little area. So see what you think that might be. All right, and then we're going to look at more cloaking objects. I'm calling it because look at this shape that's backlit with this cloud to the west at sunset. And I put enhancement on it to the right, and you can still see it holding true. You know, that's not normal in nature in a cloud formation situation. But again, see what you think. And here's one more. So just cloaking objects, just odd, you know, the shape of this thing. You look to the right, you know, where my cursor is, and it has some structure to it, you know. Pretty symmetrical, triangular, elongated triangle, you know, with these two pieces. And then something looks like it's happening here as well. We have a point up here and a point down here, so it looks like there's a larger triangle cloaking beyond with some other element popping up off of it, that it also has intelligent design to it. So again, I'm going to call it cloaking objects, could be cloaking craft. All right, well, this is the close of the show. The photo of the week is just of a nice little peacock strolling along in an urban neighborhood. I want to thank you for heading over here a while. Sorry about my voice. And just, I thank you so much for spending some time here. It is Wednesday, so I wish you a beautiful week ahead still, and just an amazing now. And I send you tremendous love and peace. Lavender Sky Panther, bye.